You ever notice how every time Samsung drops a 0.5 update, it's supposed to be small? But somehow, those are the ones that completely change how your phone feels. Well, One UI 8.5 is exactly that kind of update. It's not shouting new features from the rooftops, it's whispering them into the daily rhythm of your Galaxy. And honestly, it's smoother, smarter, and way more alive than ever before. Hey everyone, Alex here, welcome back to Smart Reviews. I've been living with One UI 8.5 on the Galaxy S25 Ultra for the past week, and I've gotta say, this update feels like Samsung finally nailed that perfect balance between power and personality. It's the kind of software that doesn't scream for attention, but quietly makes every little thing feel better. So, let's dive right in. The first thing you'll notice the second you unlock your phone is the Zeller's new Smart Ambient Display. It doesn't just adjust brightness anymore, it adapts to AU. The moment you pick up your phone, it subtly shifts color warmth based on where you are. Indoors, it softens to feel cozy and natural. Step outside, and it snaps into high contrast mode that just pops. It's the kind of polish that you can't unsee once you've used it. Small, invisible upgrades that completely change the experience. And speaking of invisible upgrades, Hess AI Scene Awareness might be one of my favorite parts of One UI 8.5. It learns how you use your phone through the day. Not in a creepy way, but just enough to make your experience seamless. Watching Netflix, it auto-tunes your refresh rate and color tones for that cinematic look. Scrolling through social media at 2 a.m, it dials down harsh whites and reduces eye strain automatically. It's like your Galaxy finally gets you. As multitasking also got some serious attention, Samsung took what was already great in One UI 8 and made it feel faster, cleaner, and just more natural. You can now resize split-screen apps with pixel-level precision. And the new Snap Layer feature, this one's genius, lets you keep one app like YouTube Maps or even Notes floating on top while you use another. It's buttery smooth, no lag, and actually feels like something that belongs in 2025. Then there's the quick panel redesign, flatter, more fluid, and way more customizable. You can rearrange tiles with a simple drag, and the animation when pulling it down feels instant. Plus, there's a new Smart Controls hub that puts Bluetooth, Wi-Fi hotspot, and cast controls in one expandable tile. It sounds simple, but it genuinely cuts down on time wasted jumping through menus. Now, customization. SAI Wallpapers is Samsung's answer to Google's AI Wallpapers, but it's all local, no internet needed. You can type prompts like, futuristic skyline at dusk, or dark gradient waves, and it'll generate beautiful wallpapers right on your device. They're unique, private, and stunningly detailed, like each phone gets its own art style. Moving over to the WAR's camera, things get spicy. Lens switching is snappier, the shutter delay is shorter, and image processing feels more natural. But the big highlight is AI reframing. Snap a shot and it automatically suggests alternate compositions, portrait, wide cinematic, all powered by depth detection and framing algorithms. And for creators, the new Creator Assist in Pro mode gives you live histograms, focus peaking and exposure guides. You can basically treat your phone like a mini DSR. Now, health and wellness. Samsung's been leaning into this more every update. In 8.5, Samsung Health got more responsive. It auto-detects workouts like running, cycling, or even yoga faster than before. And the new Mindful Pause mode. This one's underrated. Syncs with your Galaxy Watch to detect stress levels. When your heart rate spikes, your phone dims, soft music fades in, and it basically tells you, hey, take a breath. It's subtle, but surprisingly powerful. Battery life has always been a mixed story on One UI, but 8.5 brings something that feels like long-term thinking. Smart charging schedule. It learns your routine, holds your phone at 80% overnight, and tops it off right before you wake up. This not only preserves battery health but makes charging feel smarter, and you'll feel a difference in how everything moves. Samsung calls this Dynamic Motion 3.0 AZIX, animations that respond to touch physics, inertia, and depth. Opening apps, unlocking, or swiping feels real, less floaty, more connected. Every animation feels like it has purpose, no wasted frames, no lag. For my multitaskers out there, as Samsung DeX just keeps getting better. Wireless DeX now supports up to 120Hz compatible monitors, plus file drag and drop between phone and PC finally feels native. The boundary between mobile and desktop is basically gone. You could genuinely work off your phone all day. After spending a full week on One UI 8.5, here's the verdict. This isn't a flashy update built for screenshots or marketing slides. It's built for as living with your phone. Everything's smoother, smarter, and more consistent. The battery's better, the performance feels refined, and there's this new sense of cohesion across apps that One UI 8 didn't quite nail. It's not just an Android skin anymore, it's Samsung's identity. Thoughtful, predictable, personal, and honestly, it might be the most refined version of One UI we've ever seen. So, if your phone hasn't gotten the update yet, don't worry, it's rolling out in phases starting with the Galaxy S25, S24, and Fold 6 series. But when it does arrive, you'll feel the difference instantly. That's it for today's deep dive. If you enjoyed this breakdown and want to stay ahead of every Samsung drop before it hits stable, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe, and ring that bell so you don't miss the next one. I'm Alex. This is Smart Reviews. and I'll catch you in the next one, where we'll be talking about One UI 9, and whether Samsung might finally outsmart Google at its own game.